Among all the no-code app builders scattered across the land, I believe Flutterflow is the only god-tier no-code app builder. But what makes it god-tier? And is it the right app builder for you? Maybe. So watch to find out. When I say Flutterflow is god-tier, here's what I don't mean. That Flutterflow is better than custom code, that it's even as good as custom code, and everyone needs to use Flutterflow. All I'm saying is based on the metrics I use to evaluate a no-code app builder, Flutterflow scores full marks. In this video, I'll go over the metrics and show you how Flutterflow does it all. Something no other app builder really does at the moment. Only you decide whether or not it matches your need. Maybe you don't believe in God. We'll also look at criticism of Flutterflow and why I think any of them are really that convincing. Let's start with my 7 no-code app builder comparison metrics. The 7 metrics are customization options, make powerful apps with built-in components alone, extend with custom code, further customize with my own code, templates, minimum edits needed to be launch ready, code export, can download source code anytime, success stories, lots of finished projects on their showcase page, mobile and web, can build both a mobile and web app if I want, documentation, can refer to official guides if stuck on a range of topics. Taken together, I think it gives a pretty accurate and reliable estimate regardless of individual needs. And a few months ago, I used it to make tier list ranking no-code app builders, one for web and one for mobile. I know different metrics will matter more to one person and less to another. That's fine. All these metrics do is tell you how much juice an app builder has. If you're not that thirsty, get the one with less juice. If you're super thirsty like these Casanovas, get the one with more juice. And therapy, get therapy. So I ranked 34 no-code app builders in total, and all of them had shortcomings or were just barely good enough at everything. Except Flutterflow. It scored a perfect score. It was the only god-tier app builder out of 34 competitors, including big names like DraftBit and Bubble. If you've never used Flutterflow, let me show you what I mean. Customization options. As far as drag and drop builders go, Flutterflow's builder is packed with features. On the left side, you're looking at all the widgets and elements you can place. On the right, you can edit the properties of these widgets down to really fine details. It allows you to design your screens with as much precision as you want. And once you become more familiar with how the drag and drop works, you can edit their widget tree directly. That's the hierarchy of your widgets. And the last thing I'll touch on here is how extensively you can set the actions and conditions for your app. They even let you set loops. This is as good as any app builder you'll find out there. Next, extend with custom code. Flutterflow lets you insert custom widgets, functions, and actions. A widget is any visual element on your app. Say you want a button with a specific shape. Functions are code snippets that perform specific actions. Say you want code to calculate a return value in a certain way. And actions are snippets that affect the action flow we looked at earlier. All this is already great, but Flutterflow also has a code copilot that can write custom functions for you based on instructions. Templates. You want free app templates? You want premium app templates? You want app screens and elements? You want pre-made custom code by others who share your use case? Flutterflow has it all. I think the B-roll here speaks for itself, so let's move on. Code export. Flutterflow lets you download your code in Flutter. As we can see from this short clip by another YouTuber, Illspace, Flutterflow lets you see your code, store it in GitHub, export it, or download APKs to deploy on Google Play Store. There was a time where my team and I seriously considered using no-code for a project, and this ability to export code in a cross-platform language is why Flutterflow was the top consideration. Success stories. Flutterflow's success showcase is great. A great mix of different types of apps, and what they all have in common is great and modern looking UI. AB Money, 100,000 downloads and 4.9 stars. Atlas, a financial app with 100,000 downloads, Blue Pass, an intercontinental maritime logistics web application. Not to mention the endlessly updating list of apps from the Flutterflow community forum. A ton of use cases across both web and mobile, which brings us to the next point, mobile and web. Yes, Flutterflow's main focus is mobile apps, which they are really good at. But can you build really good web apps with Flutterflow? Yes. Case in point, Quizform, DentalRx, Trust EHR. All are built with Flutterflow. And there's more. You just need to Google and you'll have other examples. So again, Flutterflow's focus is on mobile no-code apps, but they can do very good web apps too. So if you need both a mobile and web app, wouldn't it make more sense to use Flutterflow and kill two birds with one stone? And the last point, documentation. Their YouTube channel has over 400 videos documenting everything. It's all organized into playlists for you to watch and follow along. And if you prefer reading, then the documentation section is extremely detailed and ordered. You can tell they want the onboarding to be as smooth as possible. The topics are sequenced in a logical way where a complete newbie can take baby steps if they are willing to. And let me tell you, there were some app builders with dog shit documentation. Some had great documentation, but only because there was barely anything to document since there were only basic customization options. Some had great documentation and customization, but less custom code import options, or this or that, always falling short somewhere. But not Flutterflow. So overall, it's the golden standard, the God tier app builder. Of course, even gods can be criticized. So we'll take a look at three Flutterflow's top complaints and I'll share why I think none of them hold much water. Three top Flutterflow criticism. I'll just list them all out and then we'll go over them one by one. Number one, steep learning curve. Number two, no good for web apps. And number three, not as good as Flutter. I think one word is all you need to dispel these criticisms. That word is context. For a no-code app builder, Flutterflow is very powerful and feature-rich. How could it not have steep learning curve? It's a tool. The more powerful the tool, the harder it is to learn and especially master. When people say Flutterflow has a steep learning curve, to me, it's not a criticism. It's an unavoidable side effect. So the first criticism, busted. And again, if you take it within context, Flutterflow is mobile first, web second. They're trying to bring up their web friendliness, but they are mobile first. So if you need a no-code app builder to build the most powerful web app in the world, Flutterflow shouldn't even be in your top 5 choices. But if your project needs both a mobile and web app, Flutterflow should be high on your list. This criticism is like saying a steakhouse that also serves drinks doesn't serve the best drinks. Well, yeah, it's a steakhouse. If you just want a drink, go to a cafe. But if you want a steak and a drink, consider Flutterflow. Second criticism, busted. And the third one, oh my lord. You know who says this? Flutter developers. Let's say you are a no-code guy on your way to the Flutterflow subreddit, where it's all love and clouds that smell like apple pie. But you take a wrong turn and end up in the Flutter dev subreddit, where if you mention Flutterflow, you'll get spit roasted harder than Riley Reid before church. And if I had to summarize the overall sentiment into one reply, it would be, don't bother with Flutterflow, man. Just learn Flutter. It's better. This is why context is everything. Not everyone wants to learn how to code. Most don't. Of course, custom Flutter code will perform better than an abstraction through Flutterflow. It's the same thing with DraftBit and React Native. In the hands of a competent developer, custom code will perform better. But how many people who seek out no-code app builders are competent developers or developers at all? Imagine asking for restaurant recommendations and everyone just says, oh, just cook it yourself, man. It's gonna taste way better. Maybe. But maybe I don't want to spend my evening learning how to cook. Third criticism, busted. So we've looked at how Flutterflow has all the things you would want in an app builder. We've also looked at why all the criticisms against it aren't really fair. This all has to do with the target users. So let's finish with that. Who is Flutterflow not for? I would say Flutterflow is not for you if you're new to no-code and not sure what you want to build. Your main focus is on web apps. You just need simple, basic apps, or you're a Flutter developer. On the other hand, Flutterflow sounds like a good match for someone who can't code, but has built no-code apps before, has a focus on building powerful and robust mobile applications, needs both mobile and web apps. To me, this sounds like someone who knows their shit. They know idea validation, testing, marketing, deploying to the app store, everything. They just can't code and don't want to learn how to. And that's when it can help to have God on your side. But wait, God doesn't exist. So maybe a God tier app builder is good enough. If I've convinced you to give it a try, link to Flutterflow is in the description. If you disagree with any of my points, let me know and let's get a discussion going. And if you haven't seen my app builder tier list, you might enjoy watching the tier list where Flutterflow was the only one that achieved God tier status. If you found this video useful, please leave a like and subscribe. And let's check out how Flutterflow spanked 14 others app builders right in the stink hole.